Hi, and welcome to this Tech Insights video. My name is Mary, and I'm an application engineer here at IFM Effector. You are here because you have either purchased or plan to purchase one of our SM series flow sensors. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to manually program the SM sensor using the display and push buttons in order to use the totalizer output. So let's get started. In a previous video, I already programmed my SM6020 to display in gallons per minute, degrees Fahrenheit, and for the totalizer to display in gallons. So in this video, I'm going to take you directly to the Output 1 menu and show you how to set up Output 1 for a totalizer output. So to begin, if you press this Enter button to go into the menu, we are then going to go down to the Extended Functions menu by going down to where it says EF and pressing Enter. So here you are in the Extended Functions menu, and if you go down, you can see where it says Output 1, which is the Output 1 menu. So if you go to Output 1 and press Enter, you can now see all of the parameters specific for Output 1. SDL1 is already set for flow, which is what we need to set Output 1 for our totalizer output. So we just need to go to Out1 and press Enter. Here it is set for H and O, which is a hysteresis normally output. A normally open output. So if you press either the up or down arrow key and hold it, you'll see the bar load, and then you can toggle through your Output 1 parameter settings. So you can see what these different settings mean on the Learn More page. However, to set it for totalizer, you need to set Output 1 to Impulse, IMP, and press Enter. You can now see that the Output 1 menu parameters have changed. You no longer have SP1 and RP1. You now have IMPS and IMPR. IMPS is your pulse value, and this is the value that you will set for how often you want a pulsed output. IMPR is your repeating pulse. If it is set for yes, you will get a pulse every time the IMPS value has gone through the sensor. If you set it for no, you get a single output once the IMPS value has been reached. So let me take you into the IMPS parameter by pressing Enter once IMPS is highlighted. Again, you will press down either the up or down arrow key until the bar loads. And the first thing you will see in the IMPS parameter is these C's across the screen. And you can set your factorization or your decimal point at which you want to set your IMPS value. So in this video, I'm just going to set it for 0.2 gallons. So once I have C.CCC, and you can see it is in gallons, I will press Enter, and it'll now give you a value at which you can set it at. It is set for 0.002 gallons right now, and I'm going to change it by holding the up arrow key, and you can see it'll scroll faster the longer you hold it, and I will set it for 0.2 and press Enter. Next, you can see IMPR, and it is set for yes. Again, if you hit the Enter key and you hold down either the up or down arrow key, you'll see the bar load, and you can toggle it for either yes or no. So in this case, if you want a pulsed output every time 0.2 gallons has gone through, you would keep it set for yes, and that way you can count those pulses to know the actual totalized value that has gone through. Or if you set it for no and you set IMPS, for example, to 10 gallons, you would get a single output once 10 gallons is reached, and it would stay high until you reset the sensor. So there you have it. That's how you can set your SM series flow sensor for a totalized output. And that concludes this Tech Insights video on the totalizer programming of our SM series flow sensors. As always, you can check out our Learn More page for helpful information on any of our products, and feel free to contact us at our service center at 1-800-441-8246 to speak with somebody who can assist you if you have any further questions. Thank you for your time, and have a great day.